Yeah.
Okay. All right, everybody. Hello. So glad you could come watch us today, or watch me. So I just want to start a little bit with a little something positive to say. I know these are really tough times, sitting home and, you know, tough on everybody, but if we can think of some kind of positive thing out of it, hopefully you're connecting more with family and getting on the phone and calling a friend that you haven't talked to for years, cleaning out some closets, which I've been telling myself to do for the last month, still haven't done, but hopefully you guys have. So that's my positive thoughts for the day. We're going to go over a little bit about what the workout is, and then we're going to get started. So Candace will start us with that.
Okay, you guys. So we're going to do 30-30, so 30 minutes on, 30 minutes off, and we're going to have the clock going. So you're going to hear the ding, but I'm going to be behind the camera. You guys are going to watch Lisa. You're going to hear me giving directions. I'll count you down when you have like 5 or 10 seconds left so you know what to expect. Same thing that we do in the studio all the time. So we're going to do the half hour workout. She's going to demonstrate the 4 strength training exercises that will, some of them will have a little, it'll be a little cardio. You know, we're going to mix it up and we're going to do like a back and forth. So we're going to do a cardio-ish exercise and then a strength-ish exercise, okay? Oh yeah, okay, so Lisa's setting up the clock for you guys. And so we're gonna get going. She's gonna demonstrate the exercises and pretty much the strength exercises, the cardio stuff. It's stuff you guys have seen before, so just follow along with what she's doing if you don't remember it, or if there's anybody new on here who hasn't seen this particular exercise that we're doing. And then modifications, you guys know, if you have knee issues, wrist issues, whatever it is, you can always take it down a notch. People are still joining. Okay. You can always take it down by not doing a jump, or, you know, coming off your wrists if you can't hold yourself up on your wrist, whatever it is. Okay. All right. So we're going to get started. Where's the clicker?
Okay. We're first for demonstrator.
Yeah. All right, so the first exercise that we're gonna do is gonna be inchworms. We're gonna start off with inchworms into a push-up. Okay, just making sure you guys can all see her. Okay, so now with the inchworm and the push-up, if you guys can't do a full-on push-up, go down to your knees. So Lisa's gonna show you what that looks like. So walk out to the plank, drop your knees, do the push-up, come off the knees, walk back, and there you go. So that's going to be 30 seconds on. Okay, the next exercise that we're going to do is going to be, if you have a rug or a mat, you can grab that, or just on the floor, whatever it is. We're going to do a plank. So go into a plank position. One leg up at a time, one knee in at a time to the opposite elbow. Do it again. One more time. One leg up, other leg up, knee in, opposite elbow, and there you go, 30 seconds. The next exercise is, can everybody hear me okay and see her okay? Just thumbs up. Okay, great, thank you. All right, so lunges with a press. So hands together, feet together, go down into the lunge, come up and press the hands above the shoulders. Good, make sure on the lunge that you get the back knee down. And if you notice the way that Lisa's doing the lunge, her knee is not, that front knee is not going over the toes, and she's getting like a 90 degree angle when she lunges down. Everybody good with that? All right. So the next exercise, so you're gonna come down onto your butt, hands go behind you, chest up, butt down, bring the knees into the chest, push out and press up. So keep going, Lisa, just so that they can get a feel for it. Good. Keep your chin tucked. Keep your legs straight. Push all the way up. Excellent. Okay. So we're going to get started here. So we're going to start with those inchworms, okay? Remember, we're doing 3 rounds, 30 seconds on, 30 seconds off, okay? And I'm going to guide you through the cues. Get ready. We're going to start right away when you hear the ding. Good. Inchworms are a really great way to warm up the whole body. Try and keep your legs straight. The straighter you can keep your legs, the harder the exercise is. 5 seconds left. And rest. So for the rest time, you guys, you can still walk in place. If you have some 5 pound weights, you know, and you wanna lift those, do some bicep curls, something like that, absolutely fine. Especially when we have an exercise that doesn't challenge your cardiovascular so much. If you wanna add a little something in the rest time, that's called active rest, and that's perfectly fine. Get ready, you got 5 seconds for set two. Okay, here we go. Okay, here we go, about 5 seconds left. Excellent, okay. So you guys can also use this rest time to go outside and look to see if your bike has arrived. Because then we're gonna do 45 minutes straight on the bike right after this. Is that exciting, right? Yes. Surprise! All right, get ready. 5 seconds for set three. And go. Ten seconds left. 5 seconds. And rest. Okay, so Lisa's gonna demonstrate for you guys what's called an in and out squat jump. So feet together, you're gonna go down into the squat, switch your hands as you go. If you can't touch the floor, she's gonna show you what it looks like from the side a couple of times. If you can't touch the floor, touch your inner ankle on the opposite side. All right, and go. Good job, you guys. I see people making their own modifications. I love that. Just go with what you can do if you can't jump. Looks really awesome. Okay, rest. Who else we got? Jen. Hey, Rita, Peggy. I'm seeing a bunch of new people. Judy. All right, we got 10 seconds to set two of these. Get ready. 5 seconds. Round two, go. Good, make sure if you are jumping, take care of your knees, guys. You know we always talk about that. Make sure you're sitting back and down. Don't lead into a jump squat with the knees going forward first. Sit back and down. 10 seconds, keep it going. Don't give up. Keep jumping, 5 seconds. And rest. Good, remember to walk in place. You can do arm circles if you want. Work those shoulders. Ten seconds left, going into round three of these. Okay, get ready, go. Okay. Keep it going. Last set, 10 seconds left. And rest. Okay, so the next one coming up is gonna be those planks where you're on your forearms. So if you don't have a mat or a rug where you're at, just grab a towel real quick. If you miss one set, no big deal. If you don't want your forearms to be on like a hard, you know, floor for your elbows. So just something you can rest your elbows on. We got 10 seconds before round one. Lisa's gonna get into the position. 5 seconds. Get ready to lift up your knees and go. One leg at a time. Knee into the opposite elbow. Leg up. Keep your core tight. Try not to let your butt go in the air. Keep your stomach pulled in. Think about pulling your belly button into your spine. Good. Keep the butt down. 10 seconds left. And rest. For that one, you guys, also I wanted to point out if anybody has a hip issue where they can't do knee to the opposite elbow, just bring the knee into the chest. If for any reason you can't do that, just do the legs up. If for any reason you can't do the legs up, just hold the plank for the whole 30 seconds, okay? Get ready, we're gonna go into round two. And go. And you're doing a great job too, Lisa. Oh, thank you. You remember, keep your chin tucked when you're doing these planks. Keep your spine aligned. Good, keep those hips down. 5 seconds left. Rest.
Very hot here. I'm gonna go open the door.
That's what we miss the most, you guys. We miss everybody saying, "Can you open the door? Can you open the back door? It's hot." We truly miss you guys. We really, really do. This is so awesome. Thank you for joining us. Get ready. We got 5 seconds. And go. Ten seconds left. And rest.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, this is, yeah. Oh, we lost the thing. Okay. So the next one we're going to do, guys, is skaters. So Lisa's going to use the next 10 seconds on the rest to show you guys what that looks like, and then we're going to go right into it. So she's going to show you from the front, and then we're going to go from the side and go right into it. You guys can begin. That was your go time. Again, taking notice of where do you feel your knees. Don't let that knee drive way forward over the toe. Going opposite, you're going one hand to the opposite angle. 10 seconds left. And rest. Get ready, we got 10 seconds for round two. Five seconds, and go. Thank you. 10 seconds left. And rest. So after this third set, you guys, for the rest after that, we're going to go into that lunge press. So during the next rest, if you want to grab a weight or something that can act as a weight to press up overhead, you can do that too. I'm going to give Lisa a 10-pound weight. Okay, get ready. Here we go. Round three. Go. Five seconds left. And rest. Go grab that weight or water jug or can of beans or whatever you want to use. Here's your weight, Lisa. Got 20 seconds. Maybe you guys want to grab a kid, go outside, see if there's a kid running around to lift over your head. Just kidding.
They should be.
They should be. They're home. All right, get ready. So we're going in 3 seconds. Lunge back, watch those knees, and now press overhead. Alternating. Make sure when you step back, you're stepping back far enough that you get a 90-degree angle. And that back knee is leading down. If you think about leading with the back knee going down, the front knee is just going to do what it's supposed to do and stay right in place with that ankle. And rest. Who's using a weight? Anybody get a weight? Nice. I love it. You crazy maniacs. Oh, yeah, Boog. You're taking it to the next level. I'm afraid of you. Get ready. We got 5 seconds. Yeah, exactly. It's going to hurt somebody with that. And round two, go. Ten seconds left. 5 seconds. And rest. Okay, 10 seconds to round three. Get ready and go. Good. Remember to keep paying attention to that back knee. Make sure you're stepping back far enough. What'll happen if you don't step back far enough is you're going to drive that knee too forward. 5 seconds left. And rest.
Yeah, that was three, right?
Yep. Okay. All right, so the next one, you're going to be sitting on your mat or on the floor or on your rug. And we're going to go into those knee and hip raises. So you're going to sit down. You've got 10 seconds. Hands go behind you, up on your hands. Yeah. Chest up, knees come in, heels down, hips up. Heels down, hips up. Keep your legs straight. Good job. How's everybody doing over here? He's in. Good. Good. Make sure you get those hips up real high. Keep your legs straight. Squeeze your butt as you raise those hips up. Good. Rest.
How you guys doing?
Thumbs up, thumbs up. Everybody looks good. Excellent. All right. Got 10 seconds to round two of these. Okay, get ready. And go. Knees in. Good. Knees in, heels down, hips up. Good. Notice when you come up, you're watching Lisa, you're getting into that kind of straight line when you raise your hips up and squeeze your butt. 10 seconds left. And rest. All right, 10 seconds left. I hope you got somebody else in the household unwrapping the bike for you. Get ready. 5 seconds to round three. And go. Good. Raise those hips up high. Squeeze on the way up. Ten seconds left. And rest. Okay, so now you guys can stand up, move the mat out of the way. We're gonna finish this off with some jumping jacks. So what we're gonna do, so this is our last round. So what we're gonna do with the jumping jacks is you're gonna go regular jumping jack up over the head. And then when I say switch, your arms are gonna go out in front of you. So out like that. So first overhead. And then when I say switch, you're gonna go in front of you. Get ready and go. You guys know what to do if you can't jump. Just let the feet go out to the side one at a time and still use your arms up into the side. And switch, arms in front. Five seconds. Good. Now I want to challenge you guys during this rest, get down and do some push-ups. You know I love push-ups. Huge strength exercise. Yeah. Yeah, Betty. I see you guys. Get down there. Yeah. 10 seconds left. Okay, 5 seconds. Get ready for the second round of your jumping jacks. We're going to finish strong here. And go. Switch. Front, front, front. Good. Okay, get ready to get down and do those push-ups if you're going to do them during your rest time. And go. Good job, you guys. Nice. This is awesome. I think we've got over 25 people on here. Get ready. Last round of jumping jacks in 3 seconds. Go. Switch. 5 seconds left. Ding, you are done, you guys. That was awesome. So can you guys all hear the music okay? Was it like loud enough to pump you up? Should I put it up a little bit? Obviously, for those of you that are joining us from Boston, if you can't hear it in my voice, I'm an East Coaster, so I'm freaking loud. So you don't have to worry about hearing my voice. So music up a little bit next time, thumbs up, yes? Okay, all right, cool, because this is our first one, so.
So every Tuesday and Thursday, 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock for you guys
on the East Coast. Yeah, right, 12 for you guys on the East. I'm pretty sure Tony's gonna still be sending the emails. I think it will always be this code. Boog, you are so funny. Can you guys all see each other? Can you guys tell me? Wait, so who's from Boston? Nina, and then I see Gosselin, right? Okay, awesome. This is so cool. So thanks fun. For joining us, you guys. And we miss you all, and we'll see you Tuesday.
Okay.
Bye.
Salads and water.
Yeah, oh, yeah. No wings tonight for the NFL draft.